Welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we are going to learn how to implement logging in our Spring Boot application, and we will try to implement best approach that will be useful for our Spring Boot project. And we will also learn practical implementation for logging in Spring Boot application. So this approach will enhance our development skills. So first we need to know why logging is required in our Spring Boot project. So as we know, logging is a critical aspect of any web application regardless of the framework or language used, such as Spring Boot, Node.js or .NET. So logging plays a vital role in monitoring the application health and behavior, because with the help of logs we can check what is the issue that we are facing and we can fix it easily. So first we will learn about the most common pattern that we are using in our Spring Boot applications or in any other framework or language that we are used. The most common pattern in application logging involves initializing a single logger file. So it can be often directly detected to console, or we can use a file for logs. So where logs from various parts of the application are aggregated into a single file. So this single file centralized collection of logs simplify the monitoring and analysis process. But just imagine, what if the logs are too large in this file and too huge? Then going through the logs will be more difficult and very painful to find. So as we know, single file of logs is very painful and time consuming process to search for the logs from a single file. So this is a one such problem I was trying to resolve. So where we can draw clear separation boundary between info logs and error logs. So we can use two different files for different logs. So for error logs we can use error log file, and for info log we can use info log file. So in case if you want to find the error log, so we will just open this error log file and we'll find the logs inside this file only. If you want to look for info logs, then we need to open this file only. No need to go to both. So okay, let's start. First we will go through normal implementation, and after that we will go through different files approach. So okay, so first we will do normal implementation and see how the crude way of logging, how single files store all the logs. So after that we will resolve this issue. So first what we need to do, as we know, the default Spring Boot use logback.xml file. So hence I will create here one logback.xml file for its configuration. So here I will go to resources folder and we'll just create new file with name logback.xml. So we need to use the same name. So here I will just paste the configuration here. So in this configuration we can see here I have defined our property name, that is logging file name. So here I have given the file name as complete log, and the logging file path is the root path. So it will go directly to this folder inside Spring Boot API generic response folder. So it will create new file here under target inside this folder, because we have defined the root path. And here I have defined the appender name as console, and here I am using console appender. So log will be printed on our console, as well as we are using second appender, that is normal file. And inside normal file we are using file appender. So these all logs will be go to this file. And here I have defined root level info. So here I am using normal file and console. These are two appender files that we have declared here. One is normal file, and second we have defined appender name is console. So these two appenders, console and normal file, I have defined inside root level tag, normal file and console. So our all logs will be goes inside this file. Complete log, if we are getting any error log, info log, so all log will be goes to this folder, because here I have defined root level is info. And as we know, root level is the topmost hierarchy, and we can see if we have defined root level is info, then it will print all the debug trace. Once I will start my application, so it will automatically create a one new file inside our Spring Boot API generic response folder, that is file name will be complete log. So after adding this configuration inside logback.xml file, let me start this application. And after that we can see it will automatically create complete hyphen log file under root folder. So let me start source main java. So here I will just start it, run. So this is a pattern that we are using, year, month, date to print the logs. And our root level is info. So here we can see logs are printed in the same pattern that we have declared inside our logback.xml file. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. So here we will check if this folder complete log file is created here, and I will just open as text file. So here we can see all the logs printed here also. So here we can see the last log is started Spring Boot generic response application in 14 seconds. So let me go to this controller class. And here we can see employee controller class that I have already created, and inside each method I have just added one log, that is inside employee controller get employee name method. And there is another method, these are all current APIs inside employee controller, and inside each method I have just added one logger, employee controller get employee method. So I will call this rest endpoint. So once it will execute, we will go here, and inside service implementation here I have already added one logs inside each method, that is inside employee service IMPL get employee method, because now we are in the employee service IMPL class. So I have just added these simple logs for now for testing purpose. So let me call this rest endpoint and we'll check the logs. So here I will go to postman and just execute get all employee API. So here we are getting the response get all employees successfully. Now let me go to console and we'll check the log, and we can check the behavior of our application through logs also. So here we can see the logs printed inside employee controller get employee method, and the second log was printed inside employee service implementation get employee method. So let me go inside our complete log files that we have created through logback.xml. So I will go and scroll down. So here we can also see the same logs inside get employee controller get all employee methods, and second log was inside employee service IMPL got employee methods. So info logs we can see here. But if you will get any error message, that will also be printed in the same file. So let me do some changes in the code, and we'll go to service IMPL class, and inside service IMPL class I will go to get all employee methods, and here I will just try to add one try block, and from try block I will just throw one exception, throw new runtime exception, just pass error message. Once it will execute try block, it will throw the exception, and catch build block will handle this exception. Exception ex. So here I will just print one log statement, that is logger. Logger dot error, and here I will add one log, that is error due to runtime exception. EX get message we will call here. So let me stop this application and start it again, and we will execute same endpoint, that is get tile employee again, and we'll check the logs again. So let me restart this application. So let me clear all the logs, but in complete log I have not cleared all the logs. So here logs are already printed up to 33 lines, so it will print. Now it will start from 34. So here first we need to check, once our application has started we will execute the rest endpoint again. So this is a normal implementation and all the logs will be goes into single file. So our application has started at port number 8080, but here we are not able to see the log. So let me close once and try to open it again. So here we can see logs are printed here, and now logs are printed up to line number 61. Our application has started, and same logs here we can see. So let me execute rest endpoint and we'll check the logs again. So our API executed successfully. So here we can see our get employee, our logs are printed here inside get employee controller get employee method, inside employee service implementation get employee method. And here is the local.error message that we have added, error due to runtime exception message, error message. So here we are able to see all the info logs and error logs in the same file, info and error logs, and same logs we can check upon console. So this is the error message that we are getting on the console also. So this will become problem once the multiple logs and logs site file size will become more and huge logs will be in the same file, then there are difficult to find the logs and search the logs in single file. So let's do some improvement and we'll use two different files for logs. To create two log files, we just need to do some configuration inside our logback.xml file. So it will automatically create two log files. One will be the error log and second will be the info log. So our error logs will goes into our error log file and our info log will be printed into info log file. Then it will be easy to find the error message. If you are facing any issue, then we just go and check the error log file and we'll fix it through code changes. So okay, let's see through the code how we can create two log files. So let me go back our logback.xml file. So let me stop this application and go back to logback.xml file. So here we need to add the configuration for both files. So let me remove this configuration. Here I have just pasted this configuration. So you can see here. Here I have defined property name, logging error file name is error log, and for logging successful error message we have used info log file. And here I have created two appenders, one appender name is info file, and this is the file path, we are using the root path, so it will goes under Spring Boot API generic response folder. So here I have defined the level is info, debug and trace level logs will be printed. So if we will get any error message, so it will not be printed in info log file. And we have created second log file for error messages. So here I have defined appender name is error file, and if we will get any error message, it will be printed inside error log file. If we will get any info warning message, it will be not printed inside our error file, it will just printed inside info log file. So this is our root level info, and we are using two appender files, error file and info file. So error log file will be for error message and info log file will be for info logs. So let me start this application and we'll see, it will automatically create here two files, one is error log and info log that we have defined here. One is error log and second is info log. So let me start this application. So our application has started. So let me check the logs. So here we can see our application has started, but folders are not created. These are created but not visible here. So let me execute one rest endpoint. So let me send call the same endpoint again. So it's executed successfully. So here we can see two log files are appeared. So one is info log. So inside info log we can see all the info logs are printed and warning message. But here we can see no error message was printed here. Only info error info message are printed here info logs. But if I will go to error log file, so here we can see only error message. If the logger.error we have added in our code, only error message is getting printed inside our error log file. So this is the configuration that we have used for to create two separate files in Spring Boot application, one for error logs and one for info logs. So by using Logback, a flexible and powerful logging framework, we can efficiently segregate info level logs and error level logs into different files. And the beauty of this configuration lies in its simplicity and effectiveness, and making it an essential practice for any robust Spring Boot application. So always remember, clear and organized logging is not just a coding practice, but a pathway to smooth our application maintenance and debugging in production level. So that's all about Spring Boot logging best practice. Thanks for watching this video.